far to this season. Being picked fourth, I definitely believe we could be higher than that, and we'll just have to prove that throughout the season. But we have a lot of depth coming in this year and a lot of great returners. We didn't lose a whole lot last year with Lexi Chavez being a fifth-year senior, still having Ashley Eichhoff and in the midfield, and Megan Lynch on the defensive end, and then with a couple of really stellar freshmen that we have added onto the roster. And with next to me, Jessica Cook, who was the preseason All-RMAC team as our center draw girl. She's going to have a really great year for us. Definitely, Patty, with the girls that we have this year from coming back from last year and with our freshmen, it just adds a lot more depth to our midfield line too. We're able to have a whole other shift of midfielders, which will, you know, like Jess or one of our midfielders, they get tired just running up and down the field, so having that whole other shift that could come in, even just for 5 minutes, just to give the girls a little break, is going to be really helpful for us this year. And again, with the depth, just being able to throw different girls in together, seeing who works well with one another, it's going to be much different compared to last year, only having 20 with three significant injuries, and this year having 30 with only three girls out right now. We have Lindenwood, who's seeded one right now. The last two years, they went to the Final Four. Lindenwood is out of St. Charles, Missouri, a very, very talented program. Are able to recruit a lot out of the JUCO schools, just because all the JUCO schools are located on the East Coast. Regis University out of Denver is number two, and they've been right around between 11 and 15 in the nation the last couple of years. And then Fort Lewis is right above us at number three. Fort Lewis is a team we've always seemed to struggle with a little bit. Last year, first time we played them out here on our turf, we lost by one. And then the second time we played them back over in Durango, we lost 12-10. For going into the second half, we were down 9-2, and we came back and still lost 12-10, so still not enough. But like what Jess and I were just talking about, having that second line of midfielders, having more subs is going to be crucial for us this year. And also, there's some times when girls just have an off day and they can't get the ball in the back of the net. To be able to have that shift of girls to be able to put in behind that other one that just can't get her stuff together, it is going to be really, really beneficial to us this year.
With our freshman class, we've really been able to mesh really well in the field, which I liked a lot, but definitely the middies. Having that extra line and relying on those freshmen to do their job out there just as well as us upperclassmen can do is really helpful. So I think that will definitely help us this season and be able to finish those games strong and actually get the win.